Hey everyone, and welcome back. I'm sorry that the last bit cut off really unexpectedly. I was getting a very important phone call that I've been waiting for all day, and that took the better part of 2 hours.
Max, get your ass over here.
So let's talk to Warren.
What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978, to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in
That's
the wrong
far.
time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
Really? I wish I would have known.
You probably could have raised a Kickstarter fund just for that one image of her covered in paint.
Had I known that. Anyway, Victoria took down my photo, so that drama ended well.
By the way, I saw Daniel's sketch of you online. Not bad, but I could do a much better job.
You can draw? I thought you were blinded by science, not art.
Art is science. Music is math, et cetera, et cetera. I'd put Stephen Hawking against Picasso any day.
Isn't he still
Hardcore.
alive?
So you must use a computer to draw.
Of course. I'd love to tweak one of your selfies with some cool graphics.
That might not suck. I'll let you know.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
Yeah, thanks. You had some cool shit on there, from Akira to Twilight Zone, which seems apropos today.
I consider myself a pop cultural pirate connoisseur.
That does sound better than thief.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
Seen it. I was more disturbed by all those emo vampire movies in there.
Can a sensitive high school boy love sensitive vampires too?
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
No, I was impressed you had faster pussycat kill kill.
Russ Meyer was a genius of black and white, plus babes with breasts.
Who would beat your sensitive ass down?
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
I need to talk to somebody, just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you saw, now!
How would you even know I was there?
Answer me,
Nothing
bitch!
but a butterfly.
You're full of shit. I'd respect you more if you told me the truth.
I don't need your respect.
You're clueless. You have no idea who I am or what I can do.
Actually, I have a pretty good idea of who you are.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Oh man, you're telling me what to
Get
do?
away from her, dude!
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal,
Stop
or that
that!
whore in the
Right
bathroom!
now!
But, like.
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren!
Go! Go! I got this!
Get
Dude
in,
just takes
Max!
it straight to the face.
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody! Nobody!
How the fuck did he, like, know? Because I made sure not to leave any
Man,
fucking trace.
Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
I genuinely have no fucking clue.
I have no idea. I know he's a Prescott.
And an asshole. Your friend really stood up for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
No, it felt like a real city for artists. Big and bright. Great for taking pictures.
Yeah. Must be hard coming back to a hick town like Arcadia again.
Not after seeing you.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Of course, it's one of the best photography programs in the country. And my favorite teacher, Mark Jefferson.
So you came back to Arcadia for a teacher, not your best friend.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I'm sorry.
I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
She does. I do. I do use them.
Haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it at my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Bird alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage, and he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max. Come on in. Don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home.
I like this game for the replayability, but also, like, after a certain amount of time, you just can't replay it because you've done everything. So it's hard to not metagame. And I've played this game so many times.
My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
Yeah, I see that.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-führer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
Okay.
She looks super happy. She looks super sad. She looks super stoned.
I actually have Chloe as my background photo for my laptop, but that's in the next game, the photo that I have of her, so I'm sure that whenever, like, we get there, I will show you guys that. Maybe I should have started with that first instead of this, but that's fine. I actually wanted the super high photo.
I think this junk swallowed her discs.
I keep forgetting that,
So it was Chloe who printed all those flyers. Who'd have thought Chloe wouldn't pay her parking tickets? She does love trouble.
Yeah.
Chloe totally changed her style. I barely recognized her. Chloe was always taller than me. We made her dad keep track of her height. Nothing but junk in this suitcase.
Maybe I should crack open a beer. My only issue is, though,
Hey, that TV used to be in the living room.
I don't know how drunk I want to get.
Look at that. Chloe and her dad were so close.
Everybody lies, no exception.
I'm not into them. Too pretentious. Houston, we have the power, but we need to find a disc to play.
So tell me, what does Max Caulfield do for fun now that she's a grown-up?
I don't feel grown-up, just more confused as I get older.
Welcome
especially
to the party.
After today.
Gee, thanks. I was hoping to hear something positive.
About me?
No, about me. Duh. I thought you'd at least be happy taking photos. Forget it.
I mean, if it offers a chance, then you make her happy. Anything to make Chloe happy. Chloe is definitely a narcissist, or some form of manipulative and abusive, because we see that later. And it sucks. Because I love
her. So tell me, what does Max Caulfield do for fun now that she's a grown-up?
I take photos. Of me, the world, everything. It may sound sad, but I have a blast.
It doesn't sound that sad.
I'm happiest when I've got a great image in my lens. I'm not lonely, not afraid.
Now that's more inspiring. I don't feel so totally hopeless.
There. Oh. I definitely think that she...
Okay, Chloe, a metal box under the bed equals secret.
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot. Even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
I see why. I bet your mom was not too happy.
She was happy enough to marry a Nazi. Reason number 356 to escape.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
What about her parents? Are they looking for her?
They're in denial. Max, I know she's missing.
I assume you know more than that.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. And poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
I genuinely feel bad for Chloe, but... she She also kind of did this to herself.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
So the reason why I say this is because every single time Max does something without her, or goes to do other shit, Chloe just gets defensive. And I understand that from a point of, like... I don't know how to describe it. I just can't rely on her for anything. And I love her. More of in a sense...
Now this is the Chloe I remember. Always smiling and laughing. Not so much anymore. Joy still works at Two Wells Diner. Best damn burgers in Arcadia. I better get one soon. I'd love to go to Paris, too. I haven't seen this place in 5 years. Seems like forever. Yum, that looks tasty. I do miss Joyce's cooking. If I took this picture, the deer would be standing on your ass. Damn, it's the couch. We used to pretend it was a pirate ship. Looks like a shipwreck now. Hey, I remember that stain. Chloe and I knocked over Joyce's wine bottle and we scrubbed forever, but it never came out. We got so busted. I guess they're aging, these books. I should be able to find the tools I need here. These are way too big. I need tiny tools for that camera. I'm singing songs about the future. This must belong to Chloe's stepdad.
So does this shitty-ass muscle car.
Check out the muscle car. Chloe's stepdad must be a gearhead.
Yep.
Look at all that food. That's like enough spam for 100 years. Poor little deer. It's not enough to kill you. They have to display your head.
There we go. Thank God it wasn't porn. The first... Jesus. I think to admit some shit, I always wanted to be like Chloe. Because I felt so much like Max and I always have.
Yes! Score!
And it's...
One of these guns is missing. I hope Chloe's stepdad isn't packing heat. Ooh, precision screwdrivers. Except, I can't reach them.
I am gonna go through everything because you're supposed to.
What the? Chloe's stepdad actually installed cameras in the rooms? For real? Should I switch this on? Decisions, Wowzer, a map of Blackwell Academy. I wonder why. Wowzer, a map of Blackwell Academy. I wonder why. I wonder what's in those files up there. Shit! Butterfingers! Kate Marsh? Why the hell would he have pictures of her? Okay, this is getting totally weird.
I'm gonna say I've gone through them, but I'm not gonna get Chloe in that kind of trouble.
This must belong to Chloe's stepdad. No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway.
No, but... I used to listen to this song way too much. I actually was super, super into the soundtrack.
Chloe's stepdad is head of security at Blackwell. He wants to put surveillance cameras all over the school? How paranoid can you get?
He wants to protect everyone, but...
Chloe's stepfather is this asshole from Blackwell? You've gotta be shitting me.
Well, let's get tiny tools.
That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach.
Chloe is also super self-deprecating, which doesn't actually help anyone. There we go.
Yes! You have mad skills, Max.
Alright. Tiny tools.
I've got the tools. I should go back upstairs before Chloe freaks.
Also, I say that she was a little bit manipulative and abusive is because, like, I have left behind friends. I understand the feeling. I understand how awful it is. But... it sucks. It really does. But you can't hold everyone accountable because they had to move on. And it's very negative if you just continue to stay in one place. It doesn't help you. It doesn't help anything.
So?
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah, I just took them today.
Let me see. Wait, I've seen this before. No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat? In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life. Now tell me the truth, Max.
I was there, hiding in the corner.
Damn, you're a ninja.
A ninja would have cut Nathan's head off. I just took a butterfly photo.
That is so badass.
Oh yeah, I almost wet myself when I saw the gun.
So, did you recognize me?
Not at all. Your hair and clothes are so different.
I hope so. I'm sure this is all so weird to you after coming back.
Like you said, it's been that kind of day.
So you must have overheard our conversation.
Just a bit.
There is no way you didn't hear every single vowel.
Okay, I only heard something about money, drugs, but that's it.
Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
No, I didn't know what to do.
I don't blame you. That's some intense shit.
Maybe I should go to the principal.
The principal? Are you still 12? That drunk jackass only cares about cash for Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him.
Seriously, I didn't blab to anybody. Promise.
Thank God. I'll tell you more someday. And I seriously owe you, Max. I know it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
That's so cool you remembered my birthday. But I can't take this.
Of course you can. My dad would be pissed if I never used it, and now I know it'll be used awesomely. And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool?
Yes, of course it's cool. Thank you. This camera is so sweet.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving. Let's thrash this place.
You're crazy.
Yep, I'm fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance! Shake that phony white ass. Or take my picture with your new camera. This song fucking rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on. Rock out, girl. Yes, break it down, Max.
Yo, turn it off. Turn it off.
How many times have I told you to stop blasting that punk shit?
Dude, the music's not even on. Asshole.
I'm coming up. We need to talk.
Oh, no fucking way. You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
Chloe, what's going on? Open this door, please.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay? Max, find a place to hide now.
Chloe.
I'm coming.
What are you doing?
Shit.
Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Just let me in now. Please.
1 second. My bra is stuck.
Don't get smart. Just let me in. Now. Please.
1 second. My bra is stuck.
I'm not screwing around, soldier. Chloe, open this door. I'm giving you exact...
Shit.
What's going on in here?
Jesus, I'm just trying on clothes. You're so friggin' paranoid.
Yeah, combat will do that to you. One of my guns is missing. Did you take it?
Oh, God, I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control?
Wait, is that grass? You been toking up again in here?
Oh, yeah, guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth. That's an order. Whose is it?
It's mine.
I'm sorry.
I will always say it's mine.
That was my joint.
Well, well. I don't like strangers in my home, especially
dopers. It's not your home.
So you're bringing drugs into my home. How about if I call the police? That'd screw up your spotless Blackwell record. You do seem to get around, Max. I'm sick of you losers dragging Chloe down. Missy, you sure do like to pop up and start trouble. Like this afternoon. You don't have anything smart to say now, do you?
Get the hell away from her, man. Stop harassing my friends.
You don't have any friends.
Like you know. You're not even a real cop. You're a fucking security guard.
Damn.
I was a soldier, Chloe.
Great. Fuck
and Max,
you.
If I see you here again, you'll learn all about real trouble.
Because you're such a badass, Max, let me show you my new toy. I'm Price. Chloe Price. Bang!
Jesus, put that thing down!
Chillax, sister. It's not even loaded. Yet.
I thought you believed in gun control.
Yes, I believe I should control the gun. It's the men who need to be checked. You trust Nathan or David? Thanks for taking the heat. We totally smacked his punk ass down, Max. He's no match for you and me now. That was an epic win. Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can hang in this hick hole.
All right.
Man, that did not go well for me.
No, but
if I want to keep my Blackwell scholarship, I shouldn't lie for anybody, even Chloe. I have to think about my own future.
awesome sauce? Totally reminds me of when we were kids. Come on, Slowpoke!
Hold on. I haven't been here in forever. So why do I feel like I was just here? Whoa. This is the exact same path I was on during my nightmare today.